Speaking of children and family, tell us a little bit about your family, and especially in the context now of being very successful as a writer. It sounds like you, even though you're working from home, probably get to spend more time at home when you are home, you know, not traveling.
That's right. That's right. Sort of the writing comes and goes. I'm fairly busy right now working on my new book, but when that's done and we're through with the editing, I'll have some time off that I can really spend some quality time, you know, take the kids to school, get them from school, take some fun day trips into Washington, D.C., where we live. I'm married to the beautiful Cody Erickson right now. We met at BYU many years ago, and we have four children. Oakley, my oldest, a girl. Mm-hmm. My next oldest is JD, also a girl. And then we have two boys, Kaysen and Colson. And they range in age from 12 to 1, and we are finished. Absolutely finished. Love them all, but we're finished.
I saw on your website you had an interview with, quote, Meredith DeBiera, which was your daughter
That's
in front of
right.
the Christmas tree.
That's
sounds
right.
like you do a lot of fun things with your family. What are some of the things that you like to do as a family?
You know what we like to do, believe it or not, my kids love going to the crazy little arcades where you spend $10 in tokens to get little tickets that you then redeem at the counter for $2 worth of cheap toys made in Taiwan. My kids love doing that. So we go to a little place in Woodstock called Stony Creek Amusement Center. Ski ball, the little basketball that you shoot, a roller skating. My kids are pretty easy to please, and really just being together is pretty fun. You know, we watch a lot of movies together. Mm-hmm. We go on walks together. They're a good bunch.
Tell me about, you are traveling quite a bit. You taught early morning seminary. Mm-hmm. What about now? What are you able to do? What kind of things do, you sound like a great scoutmaster or something like that with all the funny faces.
Oh, please.
I don't want to give any ideas.
Please.
I'm sorry.
Yes. Yeah. If anyone from my order stake is watching, I'm not that great at scouting. In fact, scouts don't like me. I have had about every calling in the church you can have, but really my favorite, I think, has been teaching early morning seminary. Sure. I taught several years ago when we lived in the Oakton stake in Northern Virginia. Now we live in the Winchester stake, as I said earlier, out in the Shenandoah Valley. Actually, where the book is based, I researched the area for Wednesday Letters, liked it so much that we bought a house out there and moved the gang out out into the boonies, as we call it out there, and we've never been happier. And I love the spirit of the kids that get up at 5 o'clock in the morning and drive into the chapel for early morning seminary and then take off for school. It's the spirit of the youth in the gospel, it's pretty inspiring, and it's really fuels me. And I hate not being there because of the travel. I have a substitute who's actually sort of 24/7 on call to help fill in for me, Sister Fleek. She's fabulous. I don't know where I'd be without her, but I wish she didn't have to teach so much, because that would mean I wasn't traveling so much. I miss the kids when I'm not there, but I don't know that there's a better calling in the church than getting to spend 50 minutes every single day with the youth. It's quite a blessing.
Yeah, I feel spoiled because I had the release time in seminary, but I always saw those early morning kids, I thought, wow, those are some kids that they've got something because they show up. But what time do you show up early morning?
We actually start fairly late. We don't start until 6:55. Other wards in our stake start as early as 6. There are some wards nearby us that start at 5:50. So pretty early.
Good for those kids.
Yeah, get the blood pumping.
Yeah. Well, I want to switch gears just for a minute in the last couple minutes that we have. You're working on some new things. What's coming up for you?
Well, I'm working on a new book called Recovering Charles, another novel. It'll be out from Deseret Books National Imprint, Shadow Mountain. It'll be out in the fall of 2008. And it's very simply about a young man who lives in New York, lives in Manhattan, and he gets word shortly after Hurricane Katrina ravages New Orleans that's where his dad had last been spotted, and he hasn't spoken to his dad in many years. So a friend of his father's convinces him to travel to New Orleans to search for his father, to try to recover his father and determine whether he survived the hurricane and, you know, is he dead or alive. And so he'll spend a couple of weeks in New Orleans learning a lot about the kind of man his father became when they were estranged. And, you know, who knows? It's very possible it won't be any good at all. We'll see. I still got to write it.
What's your hope as you look into the future as far as continue on what you're doing? Or do you have any other goals in mind that something you really like to do, maybe the political aspirations or something like that that you're looking forward to?
You know, maybe Mitt Romney opened the door for a presidential run. I've got a flag tie at home already in case I ever run for president. No, I'd like to see Christmas Charges in about to go into pre-production for a motion picture.
Really?
And I want to be involved in that and see how that whole process comes together, and hopefully we'll get a deal for Wednesday Letters as well. And maybe write some screenplays and become a little more familiar with the world of film, because that's always really fascinated me. But ultimately, I want to get to where I'm putting out a book every fall, and people are enjoying it and feeling touched by what I write. And as long as that happens, I'll be happy.
Yeah, let me just touch on that in a couple minutes we have left. I hadn't heard about the film production. So tell me about that. How did that come about for Christmas Jars? And you're hopeful also Wednesday Letters perhaps comes a film.
Well, there's a great new movie studio called Audience Alliance Motion Picture Studio, and it's founded by Keith Merrill, mm-hmm. who's probably familiar to all of your viewers. Fabulous director and a such a creative mind. I mean, he's a real creative genius. He and some partners have formed a studio whose sole purpose is to make movies that people actually want to see.
Oh.
Clean, uplifting movies that are of a very, very high quality. Not these sort of cheesy movies that come along now and again, but really powerful human interest stories. And so they have optioned the rights to Christmas Jars. They have a casting director in place, a wonderful script that Keith Merrill has written that's just beautiful, a little different from the book.
Sure.
I hope folks aren't disappointed. In fact, I know they won't be, because I think it's even better. And if all goes according to plan, they'll begin shooting later this fall, and it will be out in theaters everywhere fall of 2009.
Wow. Wow, it's such a pleasure to have spoken with you. I'm glad you're here. I wish you the best of luck on
Thank
your
you.
Future books and the films. I look forward to seeing those.
Thanks so much.
Thank you very much.
Real pleasure.